Welcome to this week's Monday Minutes. My name is Kelly.
My name is Jessie, and this week we are taking it back to basics. We are going to start talking about features in Koha. Maybe you migrated 10 years ago, 5 years ago, or just 3 weeks ago. We are going to talk about the basics in Koha. And today, Kelly is going to kick it off by showing us fast cataloging and all the different ways we can get there within Koha.
Yeah, this is fantastic, Jessie. Okay. The great news is fast cataloging is really helpful during usually your circulation staff time or those ILLs, depending on how you're managing your ILLs. Yep. Fast cataloging in Koha is a permission. So staff that has that permission can go ahead and do fast cataloging. Other softwares call it on the fly. So just getting a record into the system super quick. If you are in the cataloging module, you do have that option right from the cataloging module. The fast cataloging framework is specific and you can customize it. So you can see I have very few fields here on the form. There's nothing else going on. It's really just looking for a few things, a few key pieces of information. You can identify, you know, just like you can in other frameworks, you can identify mandatory fields or even default fields. So if you had a specific fast add item type that you wanted to make sure every record that's created through fast cataloging has that item type, you can certainly do that as well. And we have done a tutorial video on that, so we can always share that. If you are not wanting to have something like the 260 showing and you don't find it useful, we can go into the frameworks, and I'll do that after I finish here and just show you how easy that is. The other thing I noticed in our fast add framework is we have the 9 in a separate tab. Now, when we use the basic editor, we know that we have those tabs at the top, but this is probably just an extra click for your staff to have to go to that 9 tab to fill out the item type. And so we can adjust that in our frameworks, and we'll do that in a second. The second place that you can get to fast add cataloging second out of three, would be in the circulation module. So you also have an easy link there. It's going to bring your staff to the same place. I'll head over to frameworks. This would be for anyone that has access to the framework option in permissions, but we have this MARC bibliographic framework, and this has all your frameworks within the system. And I have this fast add options and hit MARC structure. You definitely usually have multiple pages of MARC fields that you have here. We don't, we just have this many MARC fields that we can edit at this moment. We talked about the 260, right, Jessie? So we can come over here, again, hit that actions, and we're going to hit edit subfields. So from here, maybe we just want to get rid of it completely. To do that, we're just going to take off the visibility of the editor and the staff interface, and we have a couple subfields. So this is B. I'm going to do that same thing on C and E. And that's going to make the visibility not there, and it's going to hide it for me. Now, you know, you could always go here and delete some. However, I would personally say you would want to just hide them. When I do that, now it's just giving me kind of that important information that it's saying, hey, it's now hidden. So I can see that hidden here.
Yep.
The last thing we talked about is the 9. If I go into the 942 and again, edit subfields, this is a tricky one. We had it in the 9 tab. We want it in the 0 tab. So that's just going to move that field over for us. We only have one subfield, so we only have to do that once. And then we hit save and we're all set. So now let's go back to home. I'm just going to click circulation, fast cataloging to see our work. So now, ta-da, it's all correct. It's exactly what I want. It's giving me those fields that I wanted, and that 9 is exactly on the same page, saving some clicks.
This is great, Kelly. So let's give them the third option of where they can find this.
Yep. So I'm going to pull up a patron's account. And the third way is if you had a patron come up to you and give you a book. You scan that book and you get this box. That book is clearly yours. It has your nameplate. It has your barcode, but for some reason it's not in your system. So if it, you have this little pop-up and you can go head over to the fast cataloging, same screen you had before, and then you would fast catalog it. And the beauty of this process, it's going to check it out right to them using that barcode again. Jessie, sometimes it's best to go back to the basics. So, you know, 2024, we're going back, hitting the OG stuff and making sure that people are comfortable with their COHA system, whether they're new or in a new position or just curious. This is a great way to learn different areas of COHA.
Absolutely. And if you have a section where you'd like us to cover, email us at outreach@bywatersolutions.com and we'll add it to the list.
Yeah, definitely. That would be fantastic. Okay. Well, have a great week.
Have a great week.